Hello. In this tech showcase, I will discuss about designing autonomous parking valet application and its deployment on WAAS network. Autonomous driving functions are complex and distributed across multiple networked components. As you can see in this video, autonomous parking valet is a good example for complex autonomous systems. Such a system comprises multiple algorithms that involve function for perceiving outside the environment, localizing information to orient the vehicle in a given environment, planning a route and following the path, and finally controlling the steerings and the velocity of the vehicle along the planned path. In this example, we aim to make easy the development effort by using built-in tools and library that MATLAB Simulink offers. WAAS node generation will be used to interface between different software components. We start this parking valet example that includes planning, control, vehicle modeling. For simplicity, we use pre-recorded data to substitute for localization information. There is a feedback loop from the vehicle model to the controller through the behavior and the motion planners. Here is the outcome of this example that comprises the component in one Simulink model. Let's take a look at each individual component. The behavior layer is responsible for activating and managing different parts of a mission planning by supplying a sequence of navigation tasks. This behavior layer assembles information from other parts of the system, such as environment model to estimate situational awareness, localization to estimate current vehicle position, map to find the global position, and global route from a mapping service, or in this particular case, from pre-recorded maps. Motion planning can be used to plan a path through the environment to reach each intermediate waypoint until vehicle reach the goal destination. This example uses a path planner LRT object to plan a path based on optimal LRT star algorithm. The vehicle control subsystem contains lateral control as well as longitudinal controller to regulate the pose and the velocity of the vehicle, respectively. Vehicle controller then applies to the vehicle dynamics model. As described until now, automated parking valet application is implemented as single model using the principle of model-based design. For the deployment of this complex system on a distributed framework such as WAAS and WAAS2, we partition this application into different sub-components. Since the model already contains functionalities divided into different subsystems, it is easy to partition this existing model for the purpose of the deployment. The single parking valet model now can be broken out into four separate models to facilitate deployment as a distributed system. Simulink signal lines going in between the various models are replaced by WAAS publish and the subscriber blocks. Motion planner, for example, calculate and send the desired trajectory to the controller over WAAS network. Before deployment to the target, you may want to simulate a whole entire system to verify its performance once again. In here, we use model reference for each functional module in one single Simulink model. In another word, behavior planner, motion planner, control, and dynamics all have their individual model references. Information exchange between models are based on WAAS messages. We can then deploy each model as a standalone WAAS node running on actual vehicle and replacing simulation dynamics by actual vehicle dynamics. By deploying this as a standalone WAAS node, you can speed up the simulation and deploy them to the target. One further thing that I would like to note here is that you may lose deterministic behavior. In that case, you will need to look into how asynchronous communication is impacting your design. It is very important to choose correct communication in your system. For example, asynchronous communication is more practical in real-time systems. So, today we discussed about partitioning approach for the automated parking system and its corresponding deployment on RAS network. This slide shows you how MATLAB Shimlink connect with RAS. I want to point out, beyond just bridging RAS with MATLAB Shimlink, you can complement a traditional RAS solutions with a MATLAB Shimlink tooling. Let's recap what we discussed today. In this tech showcase, we discussed about automated parking ballet system and its corresponding design. We use a model-based design approach using Shimlink for modeling and simulation of complex system. We also discussed about partitioning approach for such a system and its corresponding deployment on RAS network. Using automated code generation, the partitioned model can be easily deployed to the RAS middleware frameworks. Modeling approach using model-based design complement the strengths of the RAS-based frameworks. Automated code generation again enable easy transition of the system from a single model to distributed system on RAS-based frameworks. Thank you.